Okay. So, this is my next playthrough. Metal Gear Solid, and it's my favorite series of all time. Because I find it revolutionized gaming a lot. Whereas most of the, video games today are first-person shooters with very hollow mechanics. This game, it's stealth. It encourages you to avoid confrontation and at all costs. And there are ramifications if you get caught. So it's a totally different experience than most games. And I admire and appreciate the deep storytelling in these games, which turns people off, certain demographics off, but I could understand. So for this playthrough, and for the record, I haven't played this game in a while, so I'm gonna suck ass at it. And just because I'm a huge fan and this is my favorite series doesn't mean I'm elite at it. I'm no speedrunner or anything. No deaths or anything. I'm gonna fuck up at least once. Probably many, many times. So let's get this going. I'm gonna play it on normal. And I'm aware there is a remake of this game called Twin Snakes for the GameCube, but this is the original version. And I prefer the original versions of games that have been remastered. This also includes the Resident Evil 1, which I will be doing a playthrough of that game for both the original and the remastered version eventually. Anyway, I'll shut up for the cutscene.
This is Snake. Colonel, can you hear me?
Loud and clear. What's the situation, Snake?
Looks like the elevator in the back is the only way up.
Just as I expected. You'll have to take the elevator to the surface. But make sure nobody sees you. If you need to, contact me by codec. The frequency is 140.85. When you want to use the codec, push the select button. When we need to contact you, the codec will beep. When you hear that noise, press the select button. The codec's receiver directly stimulates the small bones of your ear. No one but you will be able to hear it.
Got it. Okay, I'm ready to go.
Alright, so first thing before I get started, generally on the PlayStation, character movement is governed by the analog sticks, especially today. But this game, and many games during its time, used the directional pad. Which is uncustomary, and a lot of people don't like it. I don't mind. Another is the screen on the top right, which Campbell just called the Soliton Radar, or he will be calling it. It's easy to get fixated on it because you use it to see where the enemies are moving, where their field of vision is. And often you spend more time looking at that than Snake himself. So it's kind of funny.
What was that noise?
Wait for the elevator to come down. I like the breathing animation they added in this game. It's really nice. Way ahead of its time. Hopefully that guy won't see me. Fuck. All three of them are gonna be here. Alright, made it. And there will be another cutscene.
Snake, I'm in front of the disposal facility.
Excellent, Snake. Age hasn't slowed you down one bit.
How's that sneaking suit working out?
I'm nice and dry, but it's a little hard to move.
Bear with it. It's designed to prevent hypothermia. This is Alaska, you know.
Take it easy. I'm grateful. If it weren't for your suit and your shot, I would have turned into a popsicle out there.
An anti-freezing peptide, Snake. All of the genome soldiers in this exercise are using it.
I see. I'm relieved to hear that. Already tested, huh? By the way, how's the diversionary operation going?
Two F-16s just took off from Galena and are headed your way. The terrorist radar should have already picked them up.
Behind D. Colonel, what's a Russian gunship doing here?
I have no idea. Looks like our little diversion got their attention. Now's your best chance to slip in unnoticed. There are only 18 hours left until their deadline. You've got to hurry.
Wow, he must be crazy to fly a Hind in this kind of weather.
Who's that?
Oh, sorry. I haven't introduced you to yet. This is Mei Ling. She was assigned to us as our visual and data processing specialist. She designed your codec, as well as your Soliton radar system. Contact her if you have any questions about either of them.
Nice to meet you, Snake. It's an honor to speak to a living legend like yourself. What's wrong?
Nothing. I just didn't expect a world-class designer of military technology to be so cute.
You're just flattering me.
No, I'm serious. Well, I know I won't be bored for the next 18 hours.
Come on. I can't believe I'm being hit on by the famous Solid Snake. But I'm surprised. You're very frank for a trained killer.
Looks like we both have a lot to learn about each other.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to learning about the man behind the legend. But first, let me explain about your Soliton radar system. The bright dot in the middle is you, Snake. The red dots are your enemies, and the blue cone shape represents their field of vision.
Be careful, Snake. The genome soldiers have highly developed senses of hearing and vision due to their gene therapy. Make sure you don't let them see you.
First, I want you to infiltrate the disposal site and look for the DARPA chief.
The DARPA chief was injected with the same GPS transmitting nanomachines as you.
He should appear on your radar as a green dot.
Get whatever information you can from him about the terrorists. If he's alive, that is.
Snake, your radar isn't affected by the weather, but if you're discovered by an enemy, you won't be able to use it.
Yes, it gets jammed easily, I'm afraid.
Yes, it's all made from currently existing technology. You won't be able to use it in an area with strong harmonic resonance, so be careful.
We'll be monitoring your movements by radar, so contact us by codec anytime you want.
Got it. I'll call if I'm feeling lonely.
Seriously, Snake, we're here to back you up, so call if you need some information or advice.
I'm also in charge of your mission data. Contact me if you want me to record your current status. My frequency is 140.96. It's a dedicated frequency for saving data. Don't forget it.
Remember, except for your binoculars, you're naked. You need to arm yourself with whatever weapons you can find.
I remember. First, I'm strip-searched by Dr. Naomi here, and then all my weapons are taken away. Imagine yourself put in that position.
Well, if you make it back in one piece, maybe I'll let you do a strip-search on me.
I'll hold you to that, Doctor. By the way, sorry to disappoint you, but I did manage to smuggle out my smokes.
How did you do that?
In my stomach. Thanks to the shot you gave me that suppressed my stomach acids.
Cigarettes? How are those going to help you?
You never know.
If you want to get in, there's the front door. It's the fastest way, but there's too much risk of being spotted by the enemy.
I can't just knock on the door and ask them to let me in. There's one sentry on the left and one on the right. They're armed with 5.56ers and pineapples.
What about the air duct near the door? There should also be a duct on the second floor.
I can't see it from here.
I'll let you decide the best COA. Counting on you, Snake.
Alright. So this area is the first major area. It's kind of tricky. You can either go through the front door, or there's an air duct up there. There's also a gun straight ahead, which I'm going to go grab. It's purely optional. You don't need it, but I'm going to show where it is. Watch out for these lights. Don't get spotted. That was extremely close. Takes some getting used to for the directional pad, SOCOM pistol. I'm gonna go back in here so that guard doesn't see me. Now this part's really tricky.
Surveillance camera?
You want to time it just right or it's going to see easily. Watch out for that guard. There we go. And this part, you just keep crawling. And there'll be another cutscene, and I'll talk during some of them.
Snake, this is McDonald Miller. It's been a long time.
Master, what are you doing here?
Miller is actually a character from Phantom Pain, so for people that are first-time Metal Gear players of that game, Miller is Big Boss's second-in-command.
Campbell told me about the situation here. I thought I might be of some use.
There's no one I'd rather have in a foxhole than you.
Well, I know lots about survival in a harsh environment. I've lived in Alaska longer than you. So call me if you have any questions about the flora or fauna out here. My frequency is 141.80.
And you can get many characters' codecs, and they just provide you with backstory and, you know, plot development. Tips, stuff like that. Purely optional. We'll play some in a little bit. Don't worry about getting lost. There's no way you can get lost in this area.
I moved the dark sheet to the cell in the first floor basement.
What about the vent shaft cleaning?
They just opened the vent covers. I'm about to start spraying for rats.
First floor basement ventilation shaft.
Shut those covers as soon as they're done spraying. Also, keep your eye on that woman in the cell. Don't get careless now.
Woman in the cell?
And that would be Meryl. She's a major character in this game and 4, so... I believe in that room there's a claymore, which is a landmine. Don't quote me on it. One of those back rooms has a silencer as well for the SOCOM pistol I picked up.
Press the action button to drop down.
I'm full of rations.
Use the elevator to change floors.
There should be a cargo elevator that you can take down somewhere around there. Try to find it.
Try to make a habit out of looking in first person. It helps a lot. The enemies aren't sophisticated or anything in this game, so they can't look up. They can only look forward where they're walking. They got tunnel vision, so. Use the chaff grenades to stun the computers. I mean the surveillance cameras, I should say. When I play these games, I'm extremely cautious of everything, so. Forgot which floor.
Use the elevator to change floors. To select the floor you want to go to, use the control panel inside the elevator on the left. Press up or down on the directional.
Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, it's the second floor.
Look at the radar. It's picking up the DARPA chief. He's the green dot. Hurry and rescue him.
Okay.
For a lot of these doors, you need key cards, which you get over the course of the game. So, don't worry about that now.
Ugh, kinda damn cold. I hate Alaska. Boy, oh boy, that woman is built all right.
Bathroom perfectly detailed with maggots on the floor. Ammo for the pistol. Doing crunches. Probably doing it all day. Here is Decoy Octopus. I mean, DARPA Chief. Spoiler alert.
You're the DARPA Chief, Donald Anderson, right?
You're here to save me, huh? What's your outfit?
I'm the pawn they sent here to save your worthless butt.
Really? It's true. You don't look like one of them. In that case, hurry up and get me out of here.
Slow down. Don't worry. First, I want some information about the terrorists.
The terrorists?
Do they really have the ability to launch a nuke?
What are you talking about?
The terrorists are threatening the White House. They say if they don't accede to their demands, they'll launch a nuclear weapon.
Sweet Jesus.
Is it possible?
It's possible. They could launch a nuke.
How do they plan to launch? I thought this place was just for keeping the dismantled warheads. They shouldn't have access to a missile.
What I'm about to tell you is classified information. Okay? We're conducting exercises with a new type of experimental weapon. A weapon that will change the world.
What?
A weapon with the ability to launch a nuclear attack from any place on the face of the Earth. A nuclear-equipped walking battle tank.
Metal Gear. It can't be.
You knew? Metal Gear is one of the most secret black projects. How did you know that?
We've had a couple of run-ins in the past. So that's the reason you were here at this disposal site?
Why else would I come to a godforsaken place like this?
I had heard the Metal Gear project was scrapped.
On the contrary, it's grown into a huge joint project between ArmsTech and ourselves. We were going to use this exercise as raw data and then proceed to mass production. If it hadn't been for the revolution.
Revolution?
Rex has fallen into the hands of terrorists.
Rex.
Metal Gear Rex. The code name for the new Metal Gear prototype.
Well, logic tells us that prototype things in prototype stages aren't very reliable.
They're all experienced in handling and equipping weapons.
Hey! Shut up in there, will ya?
But I thought that all nuclear warheads were equipped with safety measures. Some kind of detonation code that you have to input.
Oh, and just you wait at the end, you have to get those codes, and then the game puts you on a
it's set up so that you need to
Easter egg hunt backtrack fest.
There are two passwords.
One of the most hated parts of this series.
Baker knows one, and I know one.
Baker? The president of ArmsTech.
That's right. Each of us needs to input our password, or there can be no launch. But they found out my password.
You talked?
Psycho Mantis can read people's minds. You can't resist.
Psycho Mantis?
One of the members of Foxhound. He has psychic powers.
This is bad.
It's just a matter of time before they get Baker's too.
If they find out Baker's password...
Baker's the fat sack of shit Newt Gingrich wannabe that we'll meet up in a few minutes.
But there is a way to stop the launch.
What?
The card keys.
Card keys?
They were designed by ArmsTech, the system developers, as an emergency override. Even without the passwords, you can just insert the card keys and engage the safety lock.
And if I do that?
Yes. You can stop the launch.
That card key.
So where are the keys?
Baker should have them. Listen, you need three card keys. There are three different slots to put them in. You need to insert a card into each one of them.
Okay, three card keys. Do you know where they might be keeping Baker?
Somewhere in the second floor basement.
Second floor basement?
I heard the guards say they moved him to an area that has a lot of electronic jamming.
Any other clues?
Yes. They cemented over the entrances, but didn't have enough time to paint them. Why don't you look for the areas where the walls are a different color? Here, take this. It's my ID card. It'll open any level 1 security door. It's called a PAN card. It works together with your body's own electrical field.
FAG card.
Personal area network, huh?
It transmits data using the salts in your body as the transmission medium. As you approach the door's security devices, they'll read the data stored in the card.
And that would be the level 1 card.
Exactly. Gotcha. Okay, I'm gonna get you out of here.
Wait a minute.
What is it?
You haven't heard any other way to disarm the PAL, have you? From your bosses or anyone?
No.
Are you sure you haven't heard anything?
I just said no.
So does the White House plan to give in to the terrorists' demands?
That's their problem. It has nothing to do with my orders.
But what about the Pentagon?
Pentagon? What is it?
And for those of you that want to know why he died, it was the Fox Dye virus.
Dead.
Really complex story there.
Naomi, the chief. What happened?
I don't know. It looked like a heart attack, but...
A heart attack? No. Colonel, are you hiding something from me?
Absolutely not. Snake, you've got to understand. This op is security level red. You need the highest security clearance to get access to the complete file.
You want me to believe that you're in charge of this op, but you don't have complete access to the file?
I told you. The Secretary of Defense is in operational control. I'm just here as your support. Snake, we don't have time to debate. Get out of there and find President Baker.
All right. Check for shit in the toilet. Nothing. If you stand over here, you can see him. You can see the edge of the gun, I believe. Yeah, right there. It's funny.
Don't move. So you killed the chief, you bastard. Liquid? No, you're not. Don't move.
Is this the first time you ever pointed a gun at a person? Your hands are shaking. Can you shoot me, rookie?
Careful. I'm no rookie.
If you get the gun I showed you in the beginning, it totally changes this cutscene. If you didn't grab the gun, then he just grabs the barrel of hers and threatens her.
Too much.
You haven't even taken the safety off.
Cool hidden thing there.
I told you I'm no rookie.
That's character to this game.
Not one of them, are you?
Open that door. You've got a card, don't you?
Why?
So we can get the hell out of here.
Looks like we'll be a little delayed.
What are you doing? Don't think. Shoot!
This is basically a shooting gallery. Make sure you equip the rations because you're gonna get hit.
What are you waiting for? Shoot!
Don't talk to me like a rookie.
I'm telling you, shoot!
Yeah, just run forward when those grenades show up.
Thanks for the help.
Wait!
Staring right at your ass.
Detonation code.
Boss, I have a good idea.
Yeah, Psycho Mantis takes over her mind. Mind fucks her here. How she didn't hit him there when she was clearly in the hallway is beyond me. I mean, he was crouched right there by the door.
Naomi, I just had some kind of hallucination. Is it from the nanomachines?
No, Snake. The nanomachines are functioning properly.
So what was it?
It must have been psychometric interference coming from Psycho Mantis, Foxhound's psychic. Think of it as a mental feedback loop.
So that was Mantis.
Now we gotta find Baker. First, I'm gonna heal. Whatever I can grab here. Get a nice view of his asshole. That door requires a level 6 key card. So we're not going through that one just yet. Now be really careful on this floor because there's, see that? Traps on the floors. You also need to be careful because there's some laser tripwires on the ground in some of these rooms. What we're looking for right now is this C4 so we can blast the wall. At the end of this room to get to Baker, which will trigger the next boss fight, which will be with Ocelot. Careful. C4, there we go. And There you go. Blasted the wall. We're gonna have to do it again. Baker is right there. Let's open another cutscene where he's basically being held hostage here by Ocelot, I think. You do not want to touch any of those wires.
He's alive.
You don't want to touch any of those wires while you're fighting Ocelot in a minute, because then the whole room will explode, it'll be game over, so keep that in mind.
Don't touch it!
C4.
Right. Touch that wire, and the C4 will blow up along with the old man. So you're the one that the boss keeps talking about.
You?
Special Operations Foxhound. Revolver Ocelot. I've been waiting for you, Solid Snake. Now we'll see if the man can live up to the legend. This is the greatest handgun ever made. The Colt's Single Action Army. 6 bullets, more than enough to kill anything that moves. Now I'll show you why they call me Revolver.
And he's a pretty annoying boss.
Draw!
Probably gonna take me a good 10 minutes. Just don't touch those wires. I think I just wasted the last fucking,
Hiding won't help you. I understand the bullet shots.
I just wasted my only C4 that I need. Cause I'm a retard.
I love to reload during a battle. Alright. I'm alive. Let's go.
The trick is to shoot him when he's shooting at you. Or that'll happen.
You better hurry up. The old man's not gonna last too long. Don't you want to settle this?
God, I hate this boss fight. Fuck.
I love the smell of corner.
Got him.
But to you, it'll be the smell of your...
Shut up. My crosshair was totally on his ass.
You're pretty good. Just what I'd expect from the man with the same code as the boss. It's been a long time since I had such a good fight, but I'm just getting warmed up.
What? My hand!
Stealth camouflage. Can't you even die right? You were lucky. We'll meet again!
Who are you?
I like you. I have no name.
That exoskeleton.
Can you talk?
Who are you?
I'm not one of them. The DARPA chief told me he gave them his detonation code. What about yours?
Oh, I get it. Jim sent you. You're from the Pentagon.
Answer my question. What about your code? There's no time.
I talked.
What? Now the terrorists have both codes and can launch any time.
It's not like I didn't fight. I managed to resist Psycho Mantis' mind probe.
He couldn't read you? How'd you do it?
Surgical implants in my brain.
Surgical implants?
Kind of like a psychic insulation. Everyone who knows these top secret codes has it.
Even the DARPA chief?
Of course.
But the DARPA chief said Mantis got his code by reading his mind.
Are you sure you heard him right?
Yeah, I'm sure. In that case, how did they get your code?
I never had any training on how to resist torture.
It looks like he had some fun with you, all right.
Oh, he's not human. I tell you, he loved every second of it.
What happened to your arm?
He broke it.
Looks like you're more than even now. His was sliced off.
Ha, you're a funny man. So, the DARPA chief, is he okay?
Dead.
What? I can't be. No, that's not what you promised, Jim! Now you want to shut me up!
Calm down. What's wrong with you? I just told you I was here to save you. I didn't kill the DARPA chief. He had a heart attack or something.
A heart attack? Oh, don't be a fool.
Anyway, the terrorists have both codes now.
Those boys are totally insane. They wouldn't hesitate to launch.
I agree, but what do they really want?
Who knows? Maybe they're like us in the arms industry, always looking forward to the next good war.
Well, I'm not gonna let these maniacs start a war today. You still have the card keys?
Card keys?
To override the detonation code, I heard you had them.
No, not anymore.
What? Who does then? Not the terrorists?
No, that woman.
Woman? Who?
A soldier that was thrown in prison along with me.
A female soldier, it must be.
She said she had just joined up as a new recruit. They threw her in prison because she refused to take part in the rebellion.
A new recruit? Could that be the Colonel's niece?
I gave her the key. Looks like she managed to break out of here, though. I hope she's okay.
I'm sure she is. She's green, but as tough as they come. But how did you know she escaped?
I was in contact with her by codec. Until I was tied up here, that is.
Codec?
Yes, she stole it from the guard. If she still has it, you should be able to contact her.
I'm sure she still has it. What frequency was she at?
Oh, yeah. Let me tell you, it's... Oh, sorry. I forgot.
Damn!
Oh, that's right. It should be on the back of the CD case. Try to contact her.
I'll contact her right away. But tell me, if this doesn't work, is there some other way to prevent the missile launch?
You need to find Hal Emmerich, one of my employees.
Who's that?
The team leader of the Metal Gear Rex project. A genius at engineering, but a little bit of an oddball. If there's anyone who can figure out how to stop Metal Gear from launching, it's him.
What if he can't come up with anything?
You'll have to destroy it. Emmerich knows how to destroy Metal Gear.
Where is this Emmerich?
Well, he's probably being held somewhere in the nuclear warhead storage building. It's north from here. That's where he worked.
I understand, but why Metal Gear? The nuclear age ended with the turn of the millennium.
Oh, you're wrong. The threat of nuclear war isn't gone. In fact, it's greater than it's ever been. The amount of spent nuclear fuel and plutonium is increasing even today. Listen, have you ever seen a warehouse full of nuclear material?
No.
Drums and drums of nuclear waste stacked this high, as far as you can see. Because there's still no real way to dispose of the stuff.
So they just close the lid and try to pretend like it'll go away?
Essentially, yes. And they're not even doing a good job of storing it. Many of the drums are corroded, with nuclear waste seeping out of them.
Unbelievable.
Not only that, but several pounds of muff are reported every year.
Muff?
It stands for material unaccounted for. It proves that there's a large and well-organized black market in nuclear materials. Furthermore, since the end of the Cold War, Russian nuclear engineers in particular are out of work with no way to turn. In other words, there's plenty of available nuclear material and scientists for making a bomb. We live in an age when any small country can have a nuclear weapons program.
What about the other superpowers?
Russia and China still maintain a significant nuclear presence. Complete nuclear disarmament is an impossibility. To maintain our own policy of deterrence, we need a weapon of overwhelming power.
You mean Metal Gear?
Yes. You know our industry suffered quite a blow as a result of the cuts in military budgets due to this so-called peace.
I remember hearing a lot about mergers and takeovers among the big weapons makers.
Yes. And after my company lost their bid to produce the Air Force's next line of fighter jet, the Metal Gear system was our last ace in the hole. That's why we pushed to have Metal Gear developed as a black project.
Black project?
Secret projects paid for by the Pentagon's black budget. You can avoid a lot of red tape and get a great lead time on your weapons production. And no one can bother you. Not even those bleeding heart liberals on the Military Oversight Committee.
Bribes.
I prefer to think of it as good business. Anyway, Metal Gear was going to be formally adopted after the results of this exercise were analyzed.
I don't give a crap about you and your company.
Yes, that's about what I'd expect from a grunt like you. Here, this is what you came for, right?
What's that?
An optical disc. It's all here. The main hard drive was destroyed by gunfire. This is the only remaining copy of the data.
What kind of data?
All the data collected from this exercise. Don't play dumb. I know you were sent to get this. I hid it from that sadistic maniac while he was torturing me. They don't know this disc exists. Make sure you report this to Jim. To your boss. I'll give you my card, too. It'll open up all security level 2 doors.
Can you walk?
No. No, you go on without me. They got my password. They don't want anything else from me.
I have one more question. Who or what was that ninja thing? It looked like you knew something.
That ninja? That was Foxhound's dark little secret.
Dark little secret?
An experimental genome soldier.
You know him?
You should ask Dr. Naomi Hunter from Foxhound. She knows better than I.
Naomi.
You've got to stop them. If it goes public, my company and I are finished.
What? Doesn't Metal Gear use currently existing technology?
Metal Gear itself does, but... What? What did you do to me? Oh, no, it can't be. Those Pentagon bastards. So, they actually went in. Did it?
What are you talking about?
They are just using you for...
hell?
Colonel, are you listening? Now he's dead too.
I have no idea.
Don't lie to me.
It looked like another heart attack, but...
Some kind of poison?
Well, there are lots of drugs that can cause a heart attack in large doses. For example, potassium chloride or dioxides, but we won't be able to tell without doing an autopsy.
Damn!
Snake, I want you and Meryl to work together.
Can I trust her?
More than you can trust me. Get in contact with her.
Snake, there's a lot of electrical interference coming from there. It should be okay if you do burst transmission like us, but normal transmission is probably impossible. Try moving away from that area.
Snake, get a hold of yourself.
Naomi, what the hell was that ninja thing? A member of Foxhound?
No.
Are you sure?
Yes, we have no one like that in our unit.
Is that right?
Snake, I'm counting on you. DARPA Chief and... In any case, you should contact Meryl by codec. Wasn't her frequency written on the back of the CD case? In any case, you should contact Meryl by codec. Wasn't her frequency written on the back of the CD case?
Who are you?
I was really impressed with the way you busted yourself out of there.
The one from the prison?
You're the Colonel's niece, Meryl, right?
No, it's not him. Just exactly who are you?
I'm the fool that your uncle sent all alone into the middle of this whole mess.
You came by yourself? You think you're some kind of one-man army?
I don't need lectures. You're just like your uncle, you know?
How do you know my uncle?
We go way back.
What's your name?
My name's not important.
Aha. Could you be Snake? Are you Solid Snake?
That's what some people call me.
The legendary Solid Snake? You? Sorry about before. I wasn't sure if you were one of the good guys.
But I knew you were.
How?
It's your eyes.
My eyes?
They're not soldiers' eyes.
And they're rookies' eyes, right?
No. They're beautiful, compassionate eyes.
Oh, just what I'd expect from the legendary Solid Snake. You trying to sweep me off my feet?
Don't worry. You'll land back on them once you meet me. The reality is no match for the legend, I'm afraid.
Oh, I don't believe that.
Why did you look so surprised when you saw my face?
Because you look just like him.
You mean the terrorist leader, Liquid Snake?
Yeah, you know him? You're not brothers, are you?
I have no family.
So what's the deal then?
Who knows? Why don't you ask him? But first I want some information. You were involved in this exercise from the beginning. What exactly happened here?
I'm sorry. I was captured along with President Baker right after the terrorist attack.
That's okay. But what is this place? I don't think it's just a nuclear weapons disposal facility.
Boy, oh boy, it's just like them. Nobody told you anything, did they? Okay. You see, this place isn't really for disposing nuclear weapons. This base is owned and operated by a dummy corporation of Arms Tech.
This is a civilian base?
Right, for the development of Metal Gear.
Colonel.
Foxhound and the Next Generation Special Forces were called here for the test launching of a dummy nuclear warhead.
Why Foxhound?
Because they're a special ops group used to handling top secret missions. They figured they could help keep it all hush-hush.
But we must have fired nuclear warheads before. Why just this time?
I heard it was because this was to be a final test before the formal adoption of the Metal Gear program. Well, that's what I heard anyway.
Sounds kind of fishy. So what do you think the terrorists want?
Sorry. I'm not sure. I was captured with President Baker right after the revolt started.
Oh yeah. That's when he gave you the detonation code override keys, right?
That's right.
Amazing you were able to keep him hidden from the guards.
Well, women have more hiding places than men. Anyway, you met Baker, huh? How's he holding up?
He's dead.
What?
Heart attack. Same as the DARPA chief.
The chief died from a heart attack too?
Yeah. Was either of them sick or anything?
No, not that I heard of.
Well, I don't believe in coincidences. Something funny's going on.
Sounds like it, but I have no idea what.
Me neither. Yet. Do you know the person who designed Metal Gear?
You mean Dr. Emmerich?
Yes. Is he still alive?
Probably. He should be in the research lab in the second floor basement of the nuclear warhead storage building to the north.
Second floor basement?
Yeah, that's where his lab is. I think they're forcing him to work on the nuclear launching program.
So they'll need him alive until that's done anyway.
Then we better do something before he finishes.
You're right. In case we can't override the detonation code in time, I need to ask him how to destroy Metal Gear.
You plan to take that thing on by yourself, Snake?
It won't be the first time.
Ah.
What's the best way to get to the building where the doctor is being held?
There's a cargo door on the first floor of this building that leads to the north.
What's the security level of the door there?
5. But it's okay. I've got a level 5 card.
Well, I've got to go save the doctor. You should go.
I'm going with you.
No way. You're still too green. I want you to hide somewhere.
I'm not green.
Oh, yes, you are. You pause for just 1 second in front of your enemy and it's all over. Good luck doesn't last forever.
I don't know what happened. I just couldn't pull the trigger right away. I never had any problems in training. But when I thought about my bullets tearing through those soldiers' bodies, I hesitated.
Shooting at targets and shooting at living, breathing people are different.
Ever since I was a little girl, I always dreamed about being a soldier. Every day of my life, I've trained my mind and body for the one day when I could finally see some real action. And now...
So what now? You want to quit?
I can't quit. I can't allow myself to quit now.
Listen, Meryl. Everybody feels sick the first time they kill someone. Unfortunately, killing is one of those things that gets easier the more you do it. In a war, all of mankind's worst emotions, worst traits come out. It's easy to forget what a sin is in the middle of a battlefield.
But this isn't a war. It's a terrorist action.
You're just a little jumpy from the combat high. The adrenaline in your bloodstream is starting to thin out. Just take it easy.
But I learned all about combat high at the academy.
We'll talk about it later. For now, just think about keeping yourself alive.
If I get out of here alive, I'll think about that other stuff.
Okay. Let me try to say this another way. Stay the hell out of my way.
You're a real bastard. Just like my uncle said.
Huh. I told you. The real me is no match for the legend.
It looks like you were right. Okay, Snake. I'll be a good girl.
We'll link up after I grab the doctor. Then we'll take care of the detonation code override.
Gotcha. But listen, I know this area better than you. Call me if you have any questions.
Be careful, okay?
After I open up the cargo door, I'll contact you.